Your teacher today is Dr Bbosa Science. Dr Bbosa is a teacher at the Science Foundation College, the best school that teaches sciences. You can join the school today. Telephone contact is 07538 2709. Today, 24th September 2020, we are going to look at heterotrophic nutrition in A-level biology. Heterotrophic organisms are organisms that feed on complex, ready-made organic food. And this food, they use it as energy for vital activities. They get building materials for cell growth and maintenance. They also get vitamins and essential fatty acids that cannot be manufactured in the body. The main groups of heterotrophic nutrition include holozoic. These ones ingest, digest, absorb, then assimilate the absorbed food, then ingest the undigested food. For example, man, we eat, we digest, we absorb the digested food, we use the digested food, then we defecate the undigested food. Then we two, saprotrophic or saprophytes, for example, molds and mushrooms. This feed on dead decomposing matter. Then parasitic, this feed on living matter, for example, ringworm. One, holozoic nutrition. This type of nutrition involves the following processes. One, ingestion, taking in complex organic food, solid or liquid form. Then two, digestion, breakdown of complex organic molecules into absorbable soluble organic molecules such as glucose and amino acids. Digestion can be intracellular within the cells such as in amoeba or extracellular, for example in man. In the stomach, digestive juices are poured on the food. Digestion occurs outside the cells. Then, after digestion occurs, then absorption takes place into the cells. Then, three, absorption. This is uptake of soluble molecules from the region of digestion into the cells and bloodstreams. In man, absorption occurs in the small intestines. Then four, assimilation. This is utilization of absorbed food to provide energy or materials or structures to build the organism. Then four, digestion. This is elimination of undigested food. In man, we call it defecation. Undigested food is defecated into the toilet. Animals that feed only on plants are called herbivores. Carnivores feed on flesh or on other animals, while omnivores feed on both plants and animals. Challenges of feeding by herbivores. One, indigestible cellulose. This is overcome in two ways. One, ruminants, for example, cow, goat, sheep, developed a pouch at the anterior end of the stomach called the rumen. This one provides space for bacterial fermentation of the ingested leaf. Ruminant stomach will have four pouches. One, rumen, the second one, reticulum, the third one, omasum, then the last one is abomasum before you reach the intestine. B, other herbivores such as horse and rabbit I've got well-developed cecum, where I'm dualistic bacteria digest cellulose. The unfortunate part of this is that the cecum occurs at the end of the small intestine, so that absorption is not very effective. Actually, animals like rabbits must feed on their feces in order to obtain enough nutrients. The second challenge faced by herbivores while feeding is the low nutrient content of plant materials. This is overcome by herbivores eating large volumes of food. For example, the cow can eat from morning up to evening without stopping. The third problem is the tough plant materials to ingest. This is overcome by strong molars and premolars in a cow, sheep, and other herbivores. Tough radula in mollusks, or strong mandibles in grasshoppers. The main challenges of carnivore is obtaining food. Because they have to chase the animals or fight with them to get food. Adaptation is of carnivores to obtain food is high speed locomotion in lion, sharp claws and dagger-like teeth in great cats, sharp curved beaks in owl, sucker bearing tentacles in octopus and squid, then canal teeth. Insectivorous plants. These plants live in nitrogen deficient soil. They have green leaves to obtain carbohydrates by photosynthesis, but obtain nitrogen from trapped and digested organisms, especially insects. Parts of alimentary canals include the mouth for ingestion. Esophagus allows the food from the mouth to the stomach. Stomach has temporal storage for the food and also digestion. The pancreas produces pancreatic juice that contains enzymes which digest starch, proteins, and fats. The liver produces bile. Bile is stored in the gallbladder. Bile emulsifies fat. Small intestines digest and also absorb digested food. Colon absorbs water. Rectum stores feces. Anus allows the feces to get out of the body.
Sabasaja echi tulese mbuga fabana bokuveri muchiwanga isomere tuje riri kumutindo science foundation ifero tusemene.
The cecum and appendix in animals like horses are areas where cellulose is digested. Digestion in the mouth, the food is broken down into small pieces by the teeth. Saliva softens the food. Saliva contains salivary amylase that digests starch. Cross-section of the tooth, we have enamel, the outermost part of the tooth, and it's the hardest bone in the body. Dentine, pulp cavity, gum, cement. The part outside the gum is called the crown, and then the root, the part below, the gum. Then intersection between the crown and the root, we have the neck. Stomach offers temporary storage of food, produces gastric juice that contains hydrochloric acid. Hydrochloric acid kills germs and also provides pH for the action of pepsin. The gastric juice also contains an enzyme pepsin that breaks down proteins into short polypeptides. Pepsin is secreted in inactive form, the pepsinogen to prevent it from digesting the stomach walls. In children, gastric juice contained is renin. Renin coagulates soluble proteins to enable them to be digested by pepsin. Pepsin is produced by chief cells in the gastric gland, shown below. Gastric gland also contains parietal cells that produce adipocalic acid. Gastric gland also contains endocrine cells that produce hormones that regulate digestion. The duodenum receives secretions from pancreas and gallbladder. Gallbladder produces bile that emulsifies fats. The pancreas produces pancreatic juice. Pancreatic juice contains one pancreatic amylase that breaks down starch to disaccharides. Two, pancreatic lipase digests fats. Three, protease digests proteins, and these protease include trypsin, chymotrypsin, carboxypeptidase, and elastase. Then four, it contains bicarbonates that neutralize acidic chyme. Small intestines produce enzymes that carry out final digestion of food and absorption of food. Intestinal enzymes include maltase digests maltose to glucose. Sucrase digests sucrose to glucose and fructose. Lactase digests glucose and galactose. Four, nucleotidase digests nucleic acid to nucleotides. Adaptations of the small intestines to their functions. One, small intestines are long, allow time for digestion and absorption. Two, small intestines contain villi, which includes surface area absorption. Three, it is well supplied with blood capillaries that carry away digested food and maintain diffusion gradient. Four, the villi and the small intestine has got thin epithelium. Five, has got high concentration of mitochondria to provide energy for absorption. Six, villi contain lactate to absorb fats. Below is a drawing of the villi. The villi has got a thin outer membrane. A villi has got lactate to absorb fat. A villi is well supplied with blood capillaries. Carry absorb the food and maintain diffusion gradient. The colon absorbs water. And if you have a very long colon, you are likely to suffer from constipation because too much water will be absorbed from your food. Then the rectum provides temporary storage of feces until you deposit them in the toilet. Control of digestion. It is a complex process which involves hormones and enteric nervous system. The cells in the lining of the stomach and small intestines produce hormones that control digestion. Hormones control the secretion of digestive juice and appetite. So, feeling of hunger can be initiated by sight or by smell or by hunger. That's why we are saying it is a complex process, which involves hormones and enteric nervous system. Hormones that control digestion include ghrelin produced in the stomach. It works in the brain and increases appetite. Two, Gastrin is produced by the stomach when it is stretched. A stimulates release of gastric juice, rich in pepsin and adipocolic acid. B stimulates gastric motility. It makes the stomach move faster, the intestines, and so on. Three causes relaxation of pyloric sphincter to allow food to move from the stomach to the duodenum. Acidic pH suppresses production of gastrin. Three, secretin is produced in the duodenum, stimulates the pancreas to produce alkaline secretion. B, it slows gastric emptying, and C, stimulates production of bile. Four, another hormone that controls digestion is cholecystokinin, CCK. It is produced in the duodenum, reduces the appetite, slows gastric emptying, and stimulates release of bile from the gallbladder. Five, peptide YY, OPYY, produced in the ileum and the colon, slows gut movement to allow absorption of food. It also reduces appetite. Then six, glucagon-like peptide produced in the ileum and the colon. It slows gut motility. Then you have motilin, stimulates production of pepsin and speeds up gut movement. Thank you so much for listening. Find notes on heterotrophic nutrition and other subjects in biology from digitalteachers.co.ug. I'm also requesting you to subscribe to promote my work and also enable me to produce more videos.